We are in Livingstone, the tourist capital of Zambia. There's a lot to see here, and there's a lot to learn.
Yes, we are at Likute Lodge. So Likute stands for respect, right?
Yes, it's respect in Lozi.
I got it. Livingstone, there's a lodge, Likute. Just along the same, the road is called itself Likute as well.
Yes.
Just behind Fairmount. So just come and sample it. It's a very good lodge if you're a budget traveler like yes. ourselves.
Yes.
Yeah, so we're in Livingstone and we're having a very good time here. We're enjoying this place.
Yes.
Yeah, so we have got a lot of places to see here in Livingstone.
Yes, we have the National Museum. We've got the big falls, the Victoria Falls, which shares borders with Zimbabwe. I'm sure we all know that there's also, what do we call that? The crocodile.
The crocodile farm.
There's a crocodile farm.
You can walk with lions.
Yes, there's also the Curio Market.
Yeah, the Livingstone Curio Market.
You find a lot of these traditional baskets.
Actually, it's not Livingstone Curio, it's called, not Maramba, Mukuni.
Mukuni.
Yeah. And it's very much near here. I'm sure in the previous video you saw that it was near Likute when I took a walk in Livingstone. Okay. When you go just, I think just a few, it's walkable from here actually.
Yes, it's walkable.
Yeah, and we'll pass there and we'll check it out. Livingstone used to be the capital city of Northern Rhodesia then.
Yes.
And the capital city changed, went to Lusaka, 1935. Yeah. So this
That was 1935?
Yes, Lusaka became capital city in 1935. You and I were not there.
Wow, I missed on that history.
So when it became the capital city, Livingstone still remained a developed place. But Lusaka now started developing.
Even better than
Livingstone. So,
well,
but still,
we are not saying Livingstone is not developed.
It's nice. Me, I like it the way it is, you know. I like Livingstone the way it is.
Yes.
Actually. Yeah, so Livingstone developed into a city. Even up to now, you can still see that it's very much way better than any other towns in Zambia. Yes, Southern Province.
Yeah.
It's not a capital city. It used to be the capital of this province, but was moved to Choma.
To Choma, yes.
In 2013.
Choma.
Yeah.
Yes.
So Livingstone has even remained far better than Choma itself.
Than Choma, for sure. And it's a very clean city. You can't find any garbage near the road. It's really clean. It's like they've tried to maintain the standards for years. I was last year in 2010.
That's about 11
years
ago.
That is almost 11 years ago when I was still a little girl.
I'm sure I've seen that things have now.
Yes, a lot has changed. I couldn't even find my way into town, especially that I arrived late in the evening. I couldn't even locate the area. Even the house where I used to stay 10 years ago, it has changed.
Yeah, so the city has changed, guys, and we need it to change even more. Yeah, because Zambia is still a developing country, just like Africa, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I think in the future, I foresee a lot of investments coming to this place, Livingstone, especially the tourist sector, because this is a tourist capital of the country that we have. It's just 11 kilometers north of the Victoria Falls.
Yes.
It is served by an international airport, which has got flights from Johannesburg, Cape Town, flights from Nairobi, flights from Addis Ababa. So it's an international place anyway for international tourists.
Yes, what's the name of the airport again?
It's called Harimwanga
Nkumbula.
Named after one of Zambia's freedom fighters.
Yes, the freedom fighter.
Who is Tonga and domicile to this area.
Yes.
So they named Michael named the airport after this person. So the Harimwanga Nkumbula International Airport is not very busy, but it's busy anyway. It brings people.
Yeah, it's
people.
Busy. It's got even these local, domestic flights as well. They come here.
Yeah, the popular destination is just Lusaka.
Yes.
Anyway, but I would love to see a situation whereby somebody can fly from here to Ndola direct.
Direct instead of stopping in Lusaka. Because
like,
mostly the flights from here, they stop in Lusaka. Then the following day, that's when you can get to connect to Ndola.
So airlines, profit, Morgan, this is a message to you. At least try to make something from Livingstone to Ndola direct.
Yes, exactly.
We don't have to stop in Lusaka. So that even people from Kobe Belt can be coming here
can
for
also be coming even just one day.
They're here within a few hours later
they're back.
Yeah, also another flight maybe from here to Kasama or from here to Mbara, you know, it would be nice.
Yes, or Mongo.
Even Mongo. you know.
Because you find that from here to Mongu, you have, if you are using public transport or these Marco Polo buses, you have to reach Lusaka, spend the night there at the bus stop. That's when you start the following day. It's cumbersome.
So an influx of tourists, is local tourists especially, it's really difficult for them to.
It's difficult because if you're on a low budget where you cannot afford accommodation or food, you really struggle. You won't manage to see anything.
And I would like to commend Profit for your flash fares that you introduced, where people are able to fly at least at 1,500 kwacha, even if it seems much. But looking at how an aircraft saves time compared to buses.
To buses.
It's okay anyway.
Yes.
So just continue with the same spirit, and we also hope that you can just introduce all these things, all these airlines that can come to Livingstone and the rest of, connect in Zambia. You know, we need to connect ourselves.
Yes.
And also, if you're a local tourist, look, if somebody's able to come from Los Angeles, San Francisco, to come and just see the falls.
Exactly, and then you find
you
that
you are
the
just
local
in Kabwe. You're thinking it's too expensive.
It's too
to
expensive.
Come.
I cannot see it. I cannot.
Let me show you. We have got this couch of drinking alcohol here in Zambia. Do you know how much we spend
on alcohol? On just alcohol. On one bottle per day, it's almost
200 in a bar,
kwacha. In
which
a
is,
bar.
You can spend even 1,000 kwacha in a bar.
In a bar.
Buying for friends, just telling stories. But if you get that same money, get on a bus, like you saw the buses have been, get on an FM bus or express, what. They're cheap,
yes.
230. You are here. This room is only 250.
Exactly.
So 500 kwacha just only accommodation. You see the falls. It's so please come to Livingstone. So now what we're going to do, I think we have talked about Livingstone. So now let's show them the falls. Let's check out the Victoria Falls this time of the year, because this is the peak period of the falls. And
with
it's
the
a marvel.
Rain season just around the the rain season has already.
It's almost going,
almost
but
going
the water is now at its peak. So
yes.
Let's check out, guys, the falls. Welcome to Victoria Falls. This is at the falls, the southern end of Zambia, the southern border. Behind us, evidently, you can see the tracks going to Zimbabwe, the neighboring country, the next country, proceeding all the way to South Africa. Most of them, Durban, the port of Durban. But that's not our business. What's our business here, baby?
We are here to view the Victoria Falls,
mm-hmm.
and to show you just all the details. We want to go to the Night Bridge, want to go to boiling what?
Boiling pot. Yeah. And then, so this is the entrance to the falls. You come on the Zambian side, this is. You come this side, you find this building here. The ticket office is there. It's only 12 kwacha if you are a resident, a Zambian resident. And the non-resident is about $20.
Yes.
Yeah, so when you come, you have to pay. Then our brother there is also selling something. What are you selling? Yeah, so he's selling some phone protectors in case.
It's running too much inside.
It's running too much. The force is at its peak. So if you want to go inside the force, better you get yourself this so that you could put your phones inside this. Otherwise, if your phones are not waterproof, you'll be in trouble.
Yeah, you won't be protected.
Yeah. So now, come with us. Let's check out the force. The entrance of the force. Behind us is Mukuni Victoria Falls Curio Association. We are also curious here. If you want to come and get some curios, like the ones we saw in town, in Livingstone town, even here, we have the Mukuni Curio Village. And opposite, that's where the entrance of the Victoria Falls is, there. So you show, if you buy a ticket from the first entrance there, you come and show the people there, then so they can allow you. Then somewhere there, that's a site model there. So let's go.
Site model. Of course, the Victoria Falls itself, coming from the Zambezi River, I think that's a falls falling. Yeah, so the gorges now, this thing is divided between two countries, Zambia, the other side is Zimbabwe. You see, this part is Zambia, where we are. So we are somewhere here, we're about to go inside, cross into the Knife Ridge, onto the rainforest there. Then we'll be experiencing the falls just nearby.
In Zimbabwe, they usually watch it
from a distance,
but us will be watching it. Just here, seeing the waterfall. And down there should be a boiling pot somewhere in the gorges, whereby you'll be facing the Victoria Falls Bridge. We'll also visit the bridge, we'll be there. So this bridge, it's a rail and road crossing bridge into Zimbabwe. It's what vehicles use. Yeah, so I think it's just a model. So now let's go, we see the real thing.
So we're now going to go inside the falls.
Yes.
This is where we're going to show them our ticket. Yeah, so let's go. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
When was the last time in the falls?
I was here 10 years ago.
10 years ago.
2010.
But the goodness is it never changes anything.
No, it never.
We import this site. Now we're going to start this site, the main force.
Okay,
let's check the site map again. Okay. We are going to Knife Bridge here. Yeah. Let's check out what the Knife Bridge is all about. The boiling port is actually downwards there. So we started the Knife Bridge. Check out the Knife Bridge and come back. This is the Kiro Market where we are. And we go it like this. Yeah. So the launch of the Mark of the Africa World Heritage Day in Zambia was officially unveiled to Masatunya in 2016 by Joseph Katema. So, sweetie?
Yes, sorry, just attending to some few calls. But well, I'm very excited. I haven't been here for a very long time and I hope I find it the way I found it last time.
I can get you can get from the noise.
The sound.
You can tell the forces that it's the statue of Dr. David Livingstone. This is a statue of it's believed this is the exact point where Dr. David Livingstone. This one. It's believed this is a point where David Livingstone saw the force. I'm sure you can see from the distance how it's looking. Wow. That's just wow, why take a crowd? Wow, the falls is at its peak, guys. This is the best time to visit the falls. Just at the end of the rain season, somewhere March to July. This is the time that you need to come and see what this wonder is. Actually, it's a natural wonder. So this is Dr. David Livingstone. It's that where our town Livingstone was named after. It's believed to be the first European Scottish missionary who saw this magnificent falls for the first time. A European, actually. But there were people, there were black people anyway. He's not the one who discovered. I don't agree with that point, I guess. Wow. Just look at this, guys. Look at this. Wow, this is magnificent. This is a Victoria Falls, guys. It's not right. Look, it's magnificent, guys. You need time off for your busy schedules and come here. Just see the beauty of God, of nature, of God's creation. Yeah.
This is wonderful. This is absolutely beautiful. It's a beautiful sight to watch. Please, if you've never been here, make a date. Please come and see it for yourself. Really wonderful.
Walk gift. We're going to get wet, guys. Guys, we're now going to get wet.
Yes.
We won't be the same.
If we come out of here, I don't know the state of my hair.
We're going to shower because of this mist. When it first drops, it comes up. The shower cape.
Yes.
You can't stand
look
your
hair.
Your hair getting wet. Look it's raining. It's raining now. There.
Just a few minutes ago, it was dry.
Yeah. It's called the Albert Belt Bridge, actually. So, on this side, Zambia. This side is Zambia, this side is Zimbabwe. The river, this is still the Zambezi, but it continues after the falls. As you can see, my lady is getting wet. This is the beginning of the rain season now. It's raining,
it's
look.
It's raining here.
Coming from the falls. This is the water which is dripping from the falls and it's rising up again. The falls is at its peak. Look at how it
just
is.
Just be fast, the phone is getting wet. I'm so wet.
This is massive. Look.
Wow.
Look, guys. Look. We are a bit scared to go to the Knife Bridge. So this is a bridge. This bridge is between Zambia and Zimbabwe. Now you can see the view of the falls. There is an entire view of the falls. That's like a mini falls also somewhere there. You see? That's a boiling point. There somewhere.
Where is the boiling point?
Come and show you. You see where that water is coming from?
Mm.
There, that's a boiling. So we're supposed to go there. Now it's too wet, I think.
Oh yeah, we went there last time.
We won't go there until it's a bit dry.
And even here, that my mists are still reaching. That's the life bridge where we are at. Have you seen it?
Yes.
That's a knife bridge. We were there, guys, but we didn't feel because look at the way it's looking there. It was raining on us, guys. So this gorge, this is the Zambezi River. It continues from the falls. This is where it continues from the falls. This is Zambia. Where that one is falling from, that's Zimbabwe. Where the track is, that's inside Zimbabwe now. The country comes to an end. Okay, guys, here where we are. We are at the main state line boundary between Zambia and Zimbabwe. If you look at this poster, here, it says you are now entering what? Zambia. So this side is Zambia, then this side is Zimbabwe. And you can see behind this Victoria Falls, look at the rainbow. Wow. What do I need to see?
Wow,
look at the rainbow. Look at the rainbow. Two rainbows actually, there's one there and the other one there.
Yes, there are two rainbows. The other is the shadow of the rainbow.
Wow. And guys can tell you that the hospitality industry has really been hit. Ah, yes. Look at the bungee jumping place. Because each time you come to Livingstone, look, the rail line also crosses the same bridge. It was created for road and rail. Look at this. This place is always packed. Now it's closed like this. This is where people do bungee jumping from.
This is where, who is that one? Will Smith came.
Yeah. This is bungee jumping from. You can see this poster here, it says they're now entering Zimbabwe, which is the site. Okay. So people, I think this place is closed. Because people jump from here, then they go into woods. And there's also a cable, people move into a cable from there to there. So these are activities that you can do whilst you're in Livingstone. But now what I've seen is that, it's not happening.
It's not happening. This place needs tourists.
It's deserted, guys.
I think it's deserted. It's like the coronavirus has hit the tourist sector
badly. Because this place, if right now as I am talking, it was going to be very packed here with people, others just watching people doing the bungee jumping. It's usually packed.
What? Then you can focus on
that. This place is usually packed, guys. Now, something is wrong. We only hope that Zimbabwe is more than the other marketing people could market more of these facilities. Yeah. So this is this is the border. Hey, so guys, let's go to Zimbabwe a bit. Hey, we're now in Zimbabwe. We are abroad. Actually, you can even move up because the border post is somewhere. That's a few kilometers.
Yes.
And that's where you clear yourself. You're going to Victoria Falls Town. So we'll show you a video one time of Victoria Falls Town. It's a very good town in Zimbabwe. So this is how far we have come in Zimbabwe. And we don't want to go there. Eh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Next time.
Thanks.
Let's go back home.
All right.
All right, guys. Thank you for coming with us to Victoria Falls.